Hello there. Let's now look at task 4, which says design and develop an algorithm to evaluate a polynomial f of x equal to a4 to the power x4, a3 to the power x3, a to the power x2, a1 to the power x to the power 1, then a0 to the power x to the power of 0. That's the way we will take it. For a given value of x and its coefficient using Horner's method, implement a C program for the same and execute the polynomial and the program with different set of values and coefficients of x. So as usual, we will do bookkeeping before writing an algorithm. So we know, suppose if I have a polynomial called f of x, say equal to say 5x square plus 2 is one polynomial I have. Or if I have one more polynomial which has say 10x cube plus say 10x square plus 3. I may have one more polynomial called f of x is equal to 10x4, okay, that's it. Or I may have a polynomial called f of x is equal to 5. Now if you look at all these polynomials, right, if you look at all these polynomials, they have coefficients and the value of x. So suppose if my value of x is, suppose if f x is equal to say 2, so the value becomes pretty simple. It will be 5 into 4 plus 2, which will be equal to 22, because 2 power is if x is 2, x square is 4. Similarly, if I now have say the value of x to be again 2, in this case the equation is actually what I have 10x cube plus 10x square plus 3, which is nothing but the equation is technically like this. It is 10x cube, let me copy this, it is actually 10x cube, right, plus 10x square plus 0 into x plus 3. So the coefficient here is 0. Alright. Now if you see what I am doing here is, if I want to take x cube, I will say if x is equal to 2, I am taking 2 cube, which is nothing but 10 into so let me write it down. So it will be 10 into 2 cube is what? 8. Plus 10 into 2 square is what? 4. Plus 0 into 2 is what? Is 0. Plus 3. This 3 is nothing but this is x to the power of 0. X to the power of 0 into 3. So anything to the power of 0 is 1. So the answer here is 80 plus 40 plus 0 plus 3, which is equal to 123. So because I have substituted the value of x to be 2, so this will be 80, because 2 cube is 8, 8 into 10 is 80, plus 40 is 120, this is 0. So my answer should be 123. What is my expansion here? This is my expansion again here is, in this case 10 into x to the power of 4, correct, plus I still have to give 0, internally it is understood like this, 10 into x to the power of 3, I'm sorry, 0 into x to the power of 3 plus 0 into x to the power of 2 plus 0 into x to the power of 1 plus 0 into x to the power of 0. That's how it actually means. Now, this also can be expanded. Now, this is a characteristic of a typical polynomial. So, the degree of a polynomial here is the power of an x which has a non-zero coefficient. So, what is the power of this polynomial? Instead of saying power, I am sorry. What is the degree of polynomial? It's not power. So, the degree of polynomial in this case is x square has a coefficient non-zero and that's the highest degree. So, the degree of this polynomial is 2. So, if the degree of a polynomial is 2, then the number of elements in that polynomial will be 3. Now, the degree of polynomial here in this case is 3. So, the number of terms here will be 4. So, which I have already listed, term 1, term 2, term 3 and term 4. Now, in this case, the degree of polynomial is 4. So, I have term 1, term 2, term 3, term 4 and term 5 because the degree of a polynomial is 4. Now, what is the degree of this polynomial? The degree of this polynomial is 0 because the value of x in this case is x to the power of 0 into 5. X to the, anything to the power of 0 is 1. So, the degree of that polynomial is 1. Degree of the polynomial is 0. So, the number of elements in the polynomial, the degree is n, is always n plus 1. So, since this is 0, the number of terms in this case is 1. Correct? So, now if you see this kind of polynomial, right? Horner came up with a computing method. Now, if you look at my calculating, if I want, when I am calculating say 2q here, so the time that is required for me is 2q. Now, again when I am calculating 2 square, my time record that is, it is 2 square. Again, 2 to the power of 1, 2. So, my highest time is 2q. Instead, what I could do is, if you see, if I want to calculate 2q, I would have arrived at 2q after calculating 2 square. I would have arrived at 2 square after calculating 2. I have arrived at 2 after calculating 2 to the power of 0. That's what it actually means. Which means, instead of spending time for say O n cube, you will study in a subject called algorithms, as of now you just say O n cube. I can actually finish this in O of n, big O of n it is actually called. Right? So, I think you got it. So, what I will do now is, in this case, suppose if my polynomial, let me take an example. So, how do I do it? So, if I have an example like say 8x cube, 8, let my polynomial f of x be equal to say 8x cube, 8 into x cube plus I have 3x square, 3 into x square plus 2. So, this I will further, I will do this because the degree of the polynomial is 3. So, I should have number of elements is 4. So, I will expand it. I will say 8. I just copy this here. So, my term 1 is 8x cube plus 3x square plus 0 into x plus this is x to the power of 1. This is 2 into x to the power of 0. This is what it is. Now, if you look at this, I get a pattern here. What is the pattern? Can I map my pattern to something like this? Can I get this pattern to ax plus b form? Because I need to get it at big O of n, which is, if I am calculating 2 cube, I could have calculated 2 square before. So, what I will do is, first I will calculate my first f of x will be in stages. So, first my f of x will be 8. Next step, my f of x will be 8 into x plus the next coefficient. What is the next coefficient? The next coefficient is 3. So, I am actually getting of the form 3. I am actually getting of the form ax plus b. So, this is my next, this is my new term. Again, this term I will realize it as, now this will become my 8 into x, correct, plus 3 into x plus, I'll take the coefficient of this one, which is 0. Right? Now, third time again, next what I will do, this actually implies what? This should imply, again I will take this entire thing as one term, okay, this entire thing as one term, and that I will multiply by x, right, okay. So we had what, if you look at this, this is 8, 8x plus 3, this is 8x plus 3 into x, correct, plus 0. Now 8x plus 3 into x plus 0 into x plus 2. I will stop here. Let us see what we will get here. If you see, if I multiply this again, so what is my answer here? My inside I will get 8x square, 8 into x, 8x square plus 3x plus 0. 8x is, if I take this out, this is 8x square plus 3x plus 0 into x, correct, into x plus 2, which is nothing but again, so this will be what, 8x square plus x is 8x cube, 8 into x cube plus 3x into x is 3x square, correct, then plus 0 into x is 0 plus 2, which is nothing but my first equation, isn't it? So this is, I have found the logic now. Now if you see, I start from here. Now how do I write the logic for this? For example, I will, if the degree of polynomial say is n, so what I will do is, I will from n to 0, then it is n plus 1 term, I will accept coefficient of n, okay, then again once I do that, then I will accept n. So once I accept n, after that what I will do is, I will do this from n to coefficient of, from n to 0, what I will do is, I will do my result in the beginning will be equal to my coefficient. First I have to do, I have to take my coefficient of n, which is my coefficient of n, correct, this I will do, correct. So I have, my result is equal to, so I am supposed to get to this format, if you remember, it is this, okay, plus, so I should continue to, right, do this, so I will do into x plus my coefficient of say n. So initially what I do is, my result will be my result into 0. This will be my result. So I will have my result to be equal to 0 in the beginning. okay. So if you look at this now, if I take this same polynomial which is 8x cube, my I'll also accept, once I accept n, this I should accept actually x, right? So from first my result is 0, so 0 into this, the coefficient of n is what? Coefficient of n will be 8, so that will be 8. Next again result into 8 is, I put that into result, so my result is now 8, so it will be 8x plus coefficient of n, okay, I'll take small n, coefficient of small n, because my n I'm going from n to 0, so this will be my coefficient of n minus 1, because my I'm doing this step, okay, so once I do this iteratively, I should be able to get this final output. Am I clear? So if this is not clear, I request you to go back and again rewind and understand it properly. So let us now write an algorithm for this. Okay, algorithm for Horner's method. So first what I will do, step 1. Start. So I will say step 2, accept the degree of the polynomial then once I do that, my step 3 will be for I equal to degree to 0, so degree of polynomial is just went, I'm sorry about it. Step 3, for I is equal to degree to 0, accept coefficient of I, then accept step 4, accept the value of x. Again I will initialize my step 5, the result will be equal to 0. So again the next step 6 I will do, my step 6 is for I equal to this, my result will be equal to result into x plus coefficient of I. Okay, then display result and stop. As simple as it gets. Okay, so this is not required here, this is also not required here. I hope you understood this logic. So I accept the degree of the polynomial, the degree of polynomial is n, I have to accept n plus 1 terms. So first I will take the degree of the coefficient of the highest degree, then it will diminish into 0, I'll accept the value of x, my result is equal to 0, again from the highest degree to 0, I'll take result to x plus the coefficient. The result in the beginning is 0. I cumulative multiply x square, x cube like that. And then I'll go to the form like result into x plus coefficient of I. I'll display the result. Okay. Hope you understood this algorithm. So this algorithm, if you remember, I derived from bookkeeping. This is the only procedure that you are supposed to do. If you have not understood, just go back, rewind and watch it once again. So let us write a program on this. I'll say now, hash include stdio.h. So what all I need? I need degree. So before that I need double x, which is my value of x. Then I need double coefficient also. Now coefficient, I need an array, okay, because I have to store more than one value. So I need an array to store the coefficient. Since VTO has given up to 4, x to the power of 4, so we need 5 elements. I will go up to 10, doesn't matter. That is my double array of 10. Then I will also have int degree, okay. Then I will have int I for my, and then also have double result. As and when I am typing, you actually know why each of these are required, because we have already written an algorithm. So first what I will do is I will ask the user printf enter the degree of the polynomial. It cannot assume something to be 0. If there is a missing term, you are supposed to give that as 0. You just can't assume, it doesn't assume. Scanf percentage d and of degree. This is my degree of a polynomial. Okay. Then I have to accept the power of coefficient for each of the power. We will just make the display better. So what I will do is printf. I have to do for I equal to degree, I remaining greater than or equal to 0, I minus minus, because I am starting from the highest degree. Printf enter the coefficient of, okay, say x as a power of x to the power of percentage d, here we will give. Okay, just make the display to look better. Okay, so I will accept scanf. So what will I do? I'll say percentage lf. Lf because my coefficient is, I'll just make it small so that typing becomes easy. So my, I'll do and of coeff of 10. I'd still have to do coeff for 10 except pointers. Your theory teacher will taught you why it is, but anyhow, arrays are constant pointers. So but if you look at coefficient of I, so that also has to be given as ampersand, so that it is passed by reference, so the value gets modified. Okay, so I have coefficient of this thing. So we have written a little bit tricky code. So what we'll do is we will try and compile this. Okay, so we'll compile this code. Degree of polynomial is 2, so it should accept x square plus x1 plus x0. So it has accepted the values. So let us again display what is being accepted so that we have no problem. The coefficient of is, I have to just do printf here, nothing else. Printf, and then I will remove this and. So in this case, since I already have given, I have to accept the value of x here. So I'll just say enter the value of x. Let's say enter the value of x. Okay. So I will say scanf percentage lf and of x. Okay. So I can just put here x there as well. So I'll put percentage lf just to get that. I'll put x comma. Okay. So let us see. So I will compile this now. I have to declare x. So my x is capital, so I will keep it as capital. So this is also capital. Okay, so my OP, so degree of polynomial is 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, say 5, so it gives me, let's make the display better, I'll just make it like this, and then I'm just making display to look better. So OP, so I'll give degree of polynomial 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, value of x is say 5, so 5 cube, coefficient of power of 5 cube is 1, 5 square is 1, 5 is 1, this is 0. Okay, so what we will do now is, we will try and get the output straight away. So here, since I am already using to display, I will just say my result will be equal to 0. Anyhow, it is already 0 since I would say global variable. So inside what I will do is I will say my result will be equal to result into x plus coefficient of y. Okay. Then I will say the value of, I will say printf, the value of value f of x, f of, in this case my my x is percentage lf, value of f of x is nothing but percentage lf, which is nothing but my x and result. So that should be our output. I think our code should be, this should be fine. It's small, simple. I made it look simple. Okay, so we have some good errors. So x again. Okay, so OP, so degree of polynomial is 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, so value of x is 1, the answer should be 4, perfect. Okay, so now we will go back and try and see our code earlier that we looked at, this one. So we will see, when we will give the value of x to be, we will take this 5x square plus 2, we got 22 with x as 2, 5x square, so degree is 2. Okay, so our degree is 2, so our first element that we looked at there was 5x square, so that is 5. Next one directly we had what? We directly had this as plus 2, so we also have to give for 0x, this should be 0. So directly we had what? We had directly 2, so that will be 2. And the value of x we gave was 2. So the answer is 22. Perfect. Okay. So suppose if I have an equation like 8x cube plus 3x square plus 0x etc. Okay. This should work fine. Alright. So hope you understood this entire logic. This program works for any degree. In fact, VTO has given you go up to x to the power of 4, but you can go as well. But one thing is very sure, that suppose if you have an equation of the form 8x square plus say 10, for example, if you see this one, okay. So when we had f of x equal to 5, so if you have f of x equal to 5, that polynomial also you can give. So what is the degree of polynomial? 0. So what is the power of that? Is 5. So the value of a is independent of value of x. So even if you give 1, 1, 1, it doesn't matter because the value of f of 1 is 5 because there is only one element. So it is always a constant output. So f of x always returns a constant. Right? So hope you understood this code. Okay? Please rewind it slowly. No hurry. Okay? I want you to have this ability of converting from bookkeeping to write an algorithm to write the code. Okay? Even when you see, I also get minute errors, minor errors. It doesn't matter. Okay? The machine is going to help. Hope that this will boost your confidence. If you have any doubts, please contact me, nitinpujari@gmail.com. Thank you once again. See you in the next video. Thank you.